Thank you, Bruce. So everyone here is here for food blogging, beginner chat. All right, so who has a food blog? Raise your hand. Who's interested in starting a food blog? Who likes food? Who likes to eat, right? So I've been on the internet for a while, like teenage angst, stuff like that. So this kind of brings about some embarrassment, but I've been on a lot of journal, Zanga, and then I decided I want to get serious about food blogging, or not, actually not food blogging, just blogging in general, and I picked WordPress. So, okay. What were other options? A lot of food blogs are on Blogger. They're also on WordPress. They're on countless other platforms, Google Type. Truth be told, the reason why I picked WordPress was because I was dating a WordPress developer at the time. So he convinced me, and it worked. I got open source. I coded in BASIC when I was 10. That's the extent of my coding experience. I know HTML. You need street cred, you know, developer street cred, whatever plugins you need, whatever themes you want to pick. I thought WordPress was the best platform. So it's funny because there's tons of blogs, food blogs up there that are on Blogger, and they all tend to have the same themes. So that's something that I didn't want. So I don't know. If you want to start the blog, just plug and play, then. I don't think you need to do WordPress. All right, so everyone here loves food. You want to start a food blog because you love dining out or you love cooking. There's some recipe blogs out there. My blog is not that. I do not cook whatsoever. You might love to take pictures of food. You might see that a lot more frequently in your dining days. You might be maybe you love to write, or maybe you only like to do either pictures or just write. I actually have a friend who had an experiment where he only wrote about food without any pictures, because he thought that food blogs are getting too reliant on pictures. Like, bam, picture, and then description, and that was just enough. But I think that has its own audience. And I think Los Angeles is a great place to start a food blog, because there's a wealth of restaurants, you know. They're also shutting down, but new ones are also popping up. We're all more conscientious about the food that we like to eat and where we get them, where they're sourced from. So LA is a great place. Thank you.
photos and food go together, but...
Our Los Angeles is a fabulous food city. We have some of the best restaurants in the country. We also have one of the fastest growing food blogging communities. We like to call them, yes, the food paparazzi. They are food critics who come to restaurants armed with their BlackBerries and their cameras. If you're a real foodie, chances are you sampled one of the many food blogs in town. Living Go has a site called gastronomnom.com. Perhaps it's not the most appetizing name, but his food photos are simply mouth-watering.
Online is a visual medium, and I think like a beautiful photo, is far more visceral than two paragraphs.
On this night, Go and his blogger buddies are experiencing the culinary creations at the Trojan, a West Hollywood restaurant known for its caviar, smoked salmon, and of course, presentation.
Often it's a case of what's new. It's like what's opening, or who is the chef going to? What's kind of exciting?
The popularity of social networking is stirring up the blogger trend, and when it comes to food, it's really just a matter of taste.
It gives me a context for really celebrating and detailing and remembering and chronicling all the experiences I get to have with food.
A good photo will really grab you when you want to try and experience what the photographer is experiencing.
The food bloggers admit they feed off each other, so to speak. But what do restaurateurs think about the scrutiny of the food paparazzi?
If everybody Twitters, hey, we're going to go someplace tonight, and they post pictures of it, obviously you're going to get a response right away.
I think some chefs embrace it a lot more than others.
This blogging bunch is sure to mind their manners at the table. Out of respect for other patrons, they don't use the flash when photographing.
I never shoot when I'm in mixed company. I really only shoot when I'm meeting with other bloggers or 3D types. I really just concentrate between the food and the decor, like I want to shoot customers or servers as a chef, because again, it's kind of intrusive.
Living Go says that he'd like to be a guest judge on Iron Chef or Top Chef one day. He says that food blogging broadens the voice of food critics in Los Angeles. Reporting live in West Hollywood tonight, Leslie Miller, ABC7, Eyewitness News. All right, Leslie, thanks a lot. Dallas.
So, food blogging is hot. I don't know if you've heard of Eater. That's been the blog that's been around the most, reporting the latest openings, shutters, everything about the food community. Obviously, there's Eater New York. There was Eater New York first, and then Eater National is like the RAPS network. They launched in November 2006. And LA Times, so they've always had a food section for, as long as they've been around. They got into blogging in June 2007. So the last four, LAUP Squidding, Grub Street, Huffington Post, CNN, those are actually the sources that I get a lot of national food news, and they've only launched, they're only like a year old at most, so it kind of shows you how the momentum has carried it till recently. Do not food blog because you plan on making money. Might be obvious to some, but not everyone. I actually, maybe it's the next step for you. You're definitely more advanced than I am. You can make money and make a living off food blogging, because I don't. I have a 9-to-5, so props to you. I definitely want to talk to you. So definitely educate me if you are doing that. So I'm just gonna go over the basics of how I go about posting a post about a restaurant, a media opening, a culinary extravaganza where a bunch of restaurants are in one place. You might have heard recently, last weekend, there was a case of Beverly Hills that was held for the first time on 90210, September 2nd, and also the LA because I think I like to take the food in first and maybe kind of do the research afterwards and kind of let the palate guide me. There's no science to it, obviously, so whatever floats your boat. Go there, dine, or attend your event. Try and pick the table that's better lit, because you'll have better pictures that way. And better pictures actually, from what I've seen, do not use flash. Flash is like a no-no in food blogging because it washes out all the colors. You want to have a low-light camera to be able to grab in all the colors that you can, like low ISO and stuff like that. And while you're there, observe the service, the atmosphere, food temperature, if it's still hot, I think it's a big one. And also, while you are dining with your companions, I like to talk about it so that you can kind of formulate and articulate thoughts that you have and you can reflect later on when you're blogging about it. What you want to do is when you start your post, you want to title your post correctly. So this will take a lot of editing when you write the post and when you figure out what your theme is. But you definitely want the title of the event or the title of the restaurant obviously in your post because that's going to come up in the search. It's like just basic SEO. I'm not an SEO expert, but I found out through experience that which posts get the hits, and that's definitely through the title. When you're writing about food, lose context. Where did the chef come from? What country? What was his background? His ethnic background versus national background? Those kind of differ, and both play into his cooking or his or her cooking. Obviously, use photos. People definitely browse food blogs for photos. You might know about taste buying, only photos of food. And so people are content to look at that, pick through and find a recipe or find out where they can go eat it. They happen to live nearby. Did it measure up to your expectations? What were you expecting in the first place? And I can't stress this enough, but what is your thesis? Like, what do you want to get across to your reader about the restaurant or event? A lot of times people say, I went here, here's a picture, this is what I ate, that was great, this is delicious, or something like that. Disclose if the meal is pompous is only if you're in a media capacity when you're blogging. This is also a rule, the recent rule in the past, that it's actually more meant for the PR companies and the restaurants and the people who flaunt you, but it's always, I have to cover my ass, so. Select your categories, what kind of tags to your post. And obviously, this is good, just basic SEO, because it's going to come up in your search, or actually your readers. Search, a new reader search, when they're searching for a restaurant, neighborhood, even intersection, type of cuisine, maybe like price point, if you get that detail. And use plugins. One of the plugins that I use is actually like a map plugin, so I have to map every single location of whatever event it is that I'm posting about. So I'm going to go over just a regular post. As if I were just
can you see this
So another resource that I use is I photo manage on Flickr. So what I do is I grab the URL of whatever it is. This is my format basically, is that I have a title photo, and that immediately is meant to grab the reader's attention. And then hopefully the photo will entice them to actually start reading. So, say, this is the KCRW Pie contest. That was the Taste of the Beverly Hills for the last weekend. So, what I'll do is I'll just I will want the title of the event that I was at in my post, and the title is pie contest at the Valley Hill. I'm gonna do exactly what I said that I wasn't gonna do. It looks delicious, but I think it's really actually taste it.
Can you
show
the
pie? And then I'll say like taste of Beverly Hills. That this is my post. That's my the entire my post. And then actually I'll go into HTML. A good thing to know is just basic HTML. That way you can not get frustrated at your your enters, your double line spacing. HTML's very easy. If I can do it, so. There are actually online sites, like, I think there's HTML, just Google HTML. If you upload each photo, it just plows it down. And also, if you put, I have like 10 posts per front page, and I like to, if the post is long, I like to put a break, because otherwise all the Google Maps kind of also slow the loading time. You have like 10 or 8 versus 10, or 5 versus 10 Google Maps we're exes, but we're still friends.
Yeah. Well, loading time by loading it into the media library. Why don't we put it in there instead of going on Twitter?
Okay.
It's much shorter than you expect in the media library.
Oh, it is. Oh, really? Yeah, I mean, I've actually noticed that too, because I stopped doing that. And like, I'll have, if I have a problem with like walk internet at work or something, then I'll like upload it to my media library, but, or block Flickr, you know.
What she said to me?
Yes.
Oh, I was just saying that when I put my pictures through the media library, it's much slower to load the page versus hosting like you put a Bucket or Flickr. Because I find that it slows the loading of all of my feeds. So I find that parts of my feed take longer to load when I have everything hosted through my website.
Yeah, I think I've probably experienced that just, you know, then automatically have everything over there.
Oh, no, I've been trying to figure out why my page is so slow.
Oh, are you in the media library? Also learning to smell, like I said, so you don't drive the developer crazy. resources when you're formulating your blog posts is, you know, obviously the RedSpot website, like I was saying, it's a background. Like I said, I use Flickr, maps, and Yelp are good for the location analysis. I don't like reading Yelp before I go because you get this mass mentality towards whatever, you know, unfortunate restaurant feels their wrath. So I don't like to read those before I go and just have a clean, open mind, right? Try place. If the thesaurus is good, so for finding synonyms for delicious, colorful, and vibrant, and but don't go overboard, and I'm not going to name names, but there's this food blogger that's very notorious for using the thesaurus very generously, like having masticated things, which is another word for chew. It's funny. It's a funny community out there with lots of different vibrant personalities.
How do you
credit? Yeah.
How do you generate credit for many other
photos? Okay.
Especially with Creative Commons, do you actually put it on your webpage or just
I put it in the caption. If you're really nice, you'll put it in the body, of the post, so you're like, you know, improving your SEO. But I put it in my caption. I say photo credit to, and it's Creative Commons. Like, I'll say like the username on Twitter. So photo credit to, you know, or you can do like a CC and the logo. I get lazy. I don't like copying that logo all the time. Yeah, exactly. And sometimes they have a preference on how they want to put it, full name or website, or you might want to ask them. I like to ask because a lot of us in the food buying community like know each other, so if I know them, I'll definitely ask before. But I don't know. That's overly nice.
See a lot of blogs
Well, maybe they took it themselves, or if they obviously haven't.
You put to it. You put on the building for the site. It's not like that.
Yeah, they should be. They really should be. And it's funny, actually, the LA Times Daily just used a photo of mine without crediting me. And I knew the writer, so I just told her. Yeah. So that was nice. Yes.
And then did they credit you?
Yes, right away. I mean, as fast as the LA Times. Actually slower than most. Because they have a lot more approvals to pass. Yeah.
How frequently do you post?
I aim for Monday through Friday, once per day. It's hard, but that's my goal.
How do you eat out?
Oh, it's funny. wallet-wise, a lot of them are media events, so there's no way on my agenda I would be able to pay for everything. And they know this, so that's how it is. And I would say, like, probably half the time I get on my day, so sometimes it's lunch. I would say it's funny because I had this like 6 month period where I thought like people liked to read about me blogging, but so I would say after that to like when it became into, you know, food versus like when it finally began to take off, which probably about like a year, and that wasn't every day. It was just like once a week or twice a week and stuff. But then realizing the momentum, I was at the right place at the right time.
Do you have a lot of subscribers?
RSS subscribers or Twitter or so I have about like 400 subscribers. So
to your blog?
To my blog, yeah. I'd like to roll out a newsletter. That's a nice step on me.
What type of traffic do you typically get?
It depends on last month was August 17th. For the month. It's funny because I deviated over my content, the bulk of my content, last week because I got mugged. And I wrote about it. And Elliot, yeah, so I got like half my traffic in 3 days of August. So it's like almost my August traffic now.
Does the IRS let you conduct emails?
It's funny. So I wasn't making money until 2010, so we'll see. So now I'm going to have to deal with the taxes in 2010, but I didn't have to work in 2009. It's still a hobby. It is still a hobby, but I actually generated some freelance work.
How do you make money by the first?
That's a question for the next blogger. I have it. I'm very picky about my ad, my content. I'm very, like, I've gotten approached to have car ads, and you know what I mean? Like, so, and I would laugh back and I'm like, you can't tell. And so, you know, the food, what's that called? There's food buzz, and all their ads, you know, I mean, it's huge. There's a white background, and so I'm not ever going to do anything like that unless I can program it and develop or manipulate the code. So it's very, you know, pleasing to the eye and not deviating away from the content or directing it, not the eye away from it. Yeah?
When do you disclose to the restaurant that you're reviewing it?
So it's not a media event and it's just me visiting. Mm-hmm. I actually, it's funny because I have a different approach. Some people like to wave the, you know, like the Yelp card, but there's another, the blog card. But I like to go as if I were like a regular Joe. And that way I mean, because if I'm treated special, I'm not going to want to preach to my readers, oh, I'm this, you know, celebrity food blogger. I want to get the experience and report very truthfully about how their experience might be if they go. So very like content driven, and I don't want to get caught up in this whole thing, even though I wasn't going to take my time.
Well, they see you snapping pictures. They just assume. Do they come over
there
and ask what you're using it for?
I use like my purse nearby, and I kind of like, you know, because there's no flash, so sometimes I can get away with it. I mean, I'm not like overly cautious, but it's more and more common to see a camera in a restaurant these days. Has anyone seen it more often? Right? Yeah. Is anyone going? So, yeah, I mean, the restaurants, I'm sure they know what's going on. Never really know. I mean, now we're one in a million. Food bloggers are one in a million. So they don't know so much how much coverage is going to result. But sometimes, yeah, they'll definitely up the service, you know, and they'll treat you better. Yeah?
When the LA Times used your photo, there's the LA Times that you said?
Yes.
That was online only, not in
that
print?
That was online.
And when they credited you, did they link to you also, or just just text credit?
You can't get a link.
And they didn't pay you though.
They it's funny. They used a PR for the restaurant's PR like photo. Like I just said, oh, we can use this to the PR company, but then they used it and the credit got lost in there somewhere.
Oh, I see. So you have to go PR company. Okay.
Yeah.
So they can't just go on your site and take.
They can if they credit me. Yeah. I mean.
Do you have that set up somewhere, or is that on Flickr?
Yeah, Flickr. You can make settings so that only your friends can download your photos, or nobody can download your photos, or nobody can grab the HTML. You can make it very strict on Flickr. Very customizable. Yeah.
How did you start getting invited to these events?
Oh. I think, actually I'm going to go over that, but I think I'm going to do the next slide. There you go, how to increase your footprint. So you just keep writing and get regular posts up. I think that's the first step. That when people know when to count on when they can get new content on their site or in their RSS feed. Like, it doesn't have to be every day like me. It can be like once a week. Start small, so just establish a regular posting pattern, and then make friends with food bloggers who do have these devices, and eventually they pass your name to them, and then they, you know, the PR companies are they're definitely, because there's so many print publications that are just going out of business that food blog, they're all turning to food blogs. So that's where the PR companies are going, so it's a great time to be a food blogger, just post regularly, make friends, be on Twitter. Actually, that's probably the biggest one. Be on Twitter and follow the right people and see where they're going to be and spot them.
Do you feel like you need to have a Facebook or
a... No, they'll check. They will check. But sometimes the people with the more, with the most paid views will they know they'll be an open spot. Yes. Uh-huh.
Are you using the food trucks?
I have, just a couple of them. But yeah, I went to the Academy of Rose Bowl where they had a festival. I actually know the girls who sit on, and she's really helpful.
You mentioned FoodBuzz. Do you submit photos to FoodBuzz?
I don't.
You don't?
I know a lot of people like FoodBuzz because of the community.
Yeah, my partner's a food blogger, and she gets great traffic when she gets on FoodBuzz, but I was wondering where else you look for traffic.
I get traffic from Eater. Sometimes, like, Eater is a listage where I get a lot of
you're talking about monetization, and
and I wrote you, maybe you wrote them back and said, how are you modified? So this year you're going to make a little bit of money.
Yes. The money is actually from photography like freelancing. So it's not even, I mean, I get like, you know how I only have Google Ads, and you know how little they pay you? And versus like, you know, each click for impressions. I mean, I don't have it set that way, but I have very little, but it's just that I have to report it, and I have like nothing before. That's really the only way. Not the blog.